talk a little bit about a
big family
a stop that happened to me Saturday, heading toward Moultrie, my hometown. And I'll put the name of the little town I was stopped in on the comments. I saw a police officer sitting in the median. And I saw him, and I was doing, it's probably speed limit was 55, and I was doing 52. There was a Challenger right next to me that was purplish, kind of an off color. Looked like he was trying to challenge me, but I had already saw the police officer in the median. I actually thought that the police officer might have saw him speeding. So when I went by the police officer, I saw him talking on, like if he was talking on his radio system. And he turned his lights on and he turned around and started toward what I thought was the Challenger that was in front of me. So he pulled behind me, and since I was in the fast moving lane, I'm thinking that, oh, he possibly wants me to move over and he's gonna go at the other Challenger. So I moved over to the slower moving lane, and he followed me over to the slower moving lane. I was like, is he stopping me? I pulled over. Come to find out, he stopped me because somebody gave him a call. This is what he said, that a red Challenger was speeding at a high rate of speed in and out of traffic. And he quoted the speed as being 102 later on in the conversation. But I don't know, there's quite a few things wrong with this reason for the stop. If a person is doing 102, you ain't weaving in and out of traffic. You either going 102 straight with a clear lane. Now, I'm not saying that you can't change lanes while moving that fast, but you definitely ain't weaving. But he asked me for my driver's license and registration, and asked the reason for the stop. He told me that someone called in and said a red Challenger was driving at a high rate of speed. And I told him, no sir, officer, I am not giving you my ID for what somebody else has said. I said it would be different if you had witnessed this yourself, but no cigar. You are not getting my ID for this alleged infraction. Am I free to go? He said, no, I'll be back. And so as he was walking away, he got back to his car, and I yelled out of the window, and by the way, I am armed. He gave me the thumbs up, and I gave him the thumbs up back to let him know that I understood, that he understood that I was armed. So he came back, and then you can hear the conversation for yourself. But yeah, no ID. You're not gonna ID me for what somebody else said.
Hey, how you doing, sir?
All right.
You got your driver's license, insurance.
Oh, you saying I was speeding?
Am I saying you were speeding?
Yeah.
Well, we just got a complaint about a red Challenger just coming into the city limits by, I guess, by some drivers saying that a red Challenger driving at an excessive rate of speed. And so what we're doing is whenever we get these type of complaints, we'll make contact with the vehicle and see what's going on, see if you're in an emergency or anything.
Well, no, I'm not showing you my ID for that. Who's your supervisor?
My supervisor is Sheriff Owens.
Okay, because another driver said I was speeding. Okay. Where's your proof to that? Some other driver said I was speeding.
Listen, sir, it's not even about playing the court out here. I know what you're trying to do, but it's not even that serious, okay? The reason why
I'm not showing you my driver's license for you telling me somebody else said I was speeding. I know I wasn't speeding when I went by you.
The thing is, we gotta complain about a car traveling at excessive speed.
I don't care.
And you're endangering, you're possibly endangering people coming down on the highway. It's really not...
I'm saying
there's no reason to be like this.
Okay, well, I'm not showing you my ID for somebody telling you that a red Challenger was excessive, was speeding.
All right, so when we get a complaint about a vehicle traveling at a high rate of speed, going in and out of traffic.
I won't go on that. First of all, I wasn't doing what you're saying. They're saying I was doing. What's your name and badge? No, name and badge number, officer?
I'm Deputy Sutton, man.
Deputy Sutton?
Yes, sir.
You're stopping me for somebody else saying that some Challenger was doing this?
Yes,
no, we ain't rolling like that. I'm not showing you my ID for that. Am I free to go?
No, sir.
Okay.
So you really gonna do this?
Yeah. Because I'm on the way to a football game, and I know you guys stayed. This little town and the little town back behind there have guys on the streets stopping speeders all the time.
Okay.
So I know not the speed coming through these areas.
Okay.
First of all, because I'm from this place. Okay, I'm ready to go because I got a game to get to.
Okay. Well, okay. Look, by we having people complaining about a vehicle traveling at a high rate of speed, it's only necessary that we stop, just like if it's a suspicious person in the area.
Okay.
We have the right to check them out. You know
what? Okay,
saying?
You can check me out, but I'm not giving you my driver's license for what somebody else said. Let's say this driver that complained, me and him had a situation.
Okay.
And he wanted to play get back at me.
Well, listen, it's not even about citing you. I'm not trying to give you a ticket or anything.
Okay, well, you're not going to violate my rights for something somebody else said.
Who's violating your rights?
You are not about to violate my rights for I haven't committed a crime or that you can prove.
Okay.
So I'm not going to give you, and I appreciate you actually doing a job, because I ain't never seen a black man over in this area before, and I appreciate
right.
it, and I'm proud of you, but regardless of your skin color, you're not about to violate my rights.
Well, for future reference, I'm going to tell you, man, this is not about violating your rights, okay?
Okay.
All right, it's not about violating your rights. It's about us out here trying to do what we're supposed
to do. Okay. Well, you're going to do it within the confines of the law.
Okay.
Okay? You ain't gonna ID me for what somebody else said. Now, if you came up on me and you saw me doing it, that's a different story.
Okay.
Okay, am I free to go?
No, sit tight, okay?
Okay. And by the way, I'm armed, just so you know. It feels good.
Richland County?
Richland?
Richland.
I don't know what these counties are.
Okay. All right. Yeah. Okay.
Well, and you sure they weren't talking about a purple one? Because that dude just cut me off, by the way. It was two challengers. A dude just, I was on the way, I was in the fast lane, and I was moving up at a reasonable speed, and the dude just pulled out in front of me.
Okay. Well, I just called my dispatch. They said that it was an off-duty Richland officer who was pacing you at 122, well, pacing a red challenger.
Okay.
At 102 miles per hour. But like I said, when I called and tried to get in contact to see if the Richland officer is willing to come over here, nobody can get in contact.
Okay.
So, like I said, this is basically just a stop, just to check the status, make sure everything is good.
Okay.
Alright. I'm not trying to give you any more of a hard time.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay. But, like I said, I appreciate your job. Look, I ain't taking nothing personal, and like I'm saying, we're going back and forth, and I appreciate your job and your service.
Right. Yeah. Like I said, man, it's anytime we get calls like this, basically a suspicion call or whatever, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
It's a lot of speeders out here. It's a lot of red challenges out here.
Mm-hmm.
So, like I said, when I ask for your driver's license, okay, I definitely want the man in because we don't have much information to go on.
Absolutely.
So that's your right if you want to deny me. Now, if I had more to go by, especially if
absolutely.
I was willing to come out here, yeah, so I'm going to give you a driver's license, okay? But the guy ain't even willing.